நோடி ஆரோக்கியத்தின் அடையாளம்.
All systems are programmed to remain healthy and active till the lifetime, the prescribed lifetime is over. If we are experiencing ill health physically, mentally or spiritually, that is because of our own wrong attitudes. The free will is given to man, and we can use it either positively or negatively. And the tendency today all over the world is to use it negatively, again due to the same reasons like greed, jealousy, anger, to show our power. The lifetime is just 100 years, is nothing. It's like a quick second, you know, if you see the whole volume of time, but still we do it. So if we are facing disturbances in our health, it is because of our own creation, going against the laws of nature, going against the divine will. Now, that's why we have to talk about mostly the illness, the type of illness. Newer and newer diseases are being created and detected, and the lifetime expert, they explain why certain things are happening. Children are getting, you know, young people are suffering from diseases which should come in the old age and all that. So is it possible to lead a healthy life till our time comes to leave the planet? It's possible. So let us discuss some of the aspects of the wellness of the body, mind and spirit. Charles Dickens says there is something in sickness that breaks down the pride of manhood. Another great person said, health and cheerfulness naturally beget each other. If you are healthy, you are cheerful. If you are cheerful, it means you are healthy. Then life is not merely to be alive, but to be well. Just existence is not the purpose of life. Everything exists, but you have to be alive. He who has health has hope, and he who has hope has everything. Happiness lies, first of all, in health. Have you ever seen a sick person being happy? May you live as long as you are fit to live, but no longer. That, or may you rather die before you cease to be fit to live than after. That's been my prayer also. As long as I am able to be active, move around, be useful, I should live. The day I cannot do it, my only prayer is I should not wake up next morning. Because there should be a purpose. Mere existence is not the purpose. Unless you are healthy, you will not be a... One is, you don't enjoy life. And number two, you cannot be of any use to your family. You will become a liability to the family, burden on others, a liability to the society, and burden on the nation. So our prayer should always be, I should live as long as I am fit to live, but no longer. And I should rather, my life, my soul should leave the body before I cease to be fit to live. That should be the prayer. He says, my fat scares me. It's a ticking time bomb. Fat, when you become too fat, that's the ticking bomb. Any time it may explode. So many people spend their health gaining wealth, and then have to spend their wealth to regain their health. That is what is happening in real life. Mother Teresa said, we need to find God, and He cannot be found in noise and restlessness. God is the friend of silence. See how nature, trees, flowers, grass grows in silence. See the stars, the moon, and the sun, how they move in silence. We need silence to be able to touch souls. That's what Mother Teresa said. When we adopt meditation, this morning we had, and the Noni family does start the day with meditation every day, and that's part of silence, going within, withdrawing ourselves from all. Now, what is wellness? Wellness is a choice. Wellness is a way of life. Wellness is a process. Wellness is a balanced channeling of energy. Wellness is the integration of body, mind, emotions and spirit. Wellness is the loving acceptance of ourselves. Wellness is the right and privilege of everyone. Wellness is about learning to love your whole self. Unless you are able to love yourself, respect yourself, you can't do it to others. Wellness is about learning to love your whole self. Moving towards high-level wellness will involve the three steps of awareness, education, and growth. Health is a result of a dynamic energy exchange between the individual and everything else in creation. That is, we should be able to relate to everybody and everything in the environment. People cannot live well while remaining isolated from other people and things around them. So we should be comfortable with people around us, with the environment. We are interdependent elements in a living system. Wellness is a process, never a static state. High-level wellness involves giving good care to your physical self,